Hi, Chuck Huber here for the State A YouTube channel. Today I'd like to show you how to fit a linear regression model with a continuous predictor. If you're connected to the internet, you can use the same data set that I'm using by typing webuse-nhanes2l. And we're going to be focusing on two variables in this data set. The dependent variable is going to be BP systole, or systolic blood pressure, and the continuous predictor is going to be BMI, which is body mass index. So I can fit the model by going to statistics and then going to linear models and related, and then I'm going to click linear regression. I'm going to move the dialog box up here in the top right. And in the model tab, I'm going to begin by selecting the dependent variable, which is BP systole right here. And then for the independent variable, I'm going to select BMI, body mass index, which is way down here near the bottom. So once I've selected those two, I can click OK. And the dialog box will create the command regress, followed by BP systole, that's our continuous dependent variable, and then BMI is our continuous independent variable. In the output, we see the ANOVA table here at the top left, and some model level statistics here at the top right, the number of observations, the F statistic, the P value for the F statistic, the R squared, adjusted R squared, and root mean squared error. And then here at the bottom, we see the estimated coefficients for each of the variables in the model. So here we have the intercept, which is labeled underscore cons, and then we have the estimated coefficient for BMI, which is 1.656894. We also get a standard error, a t-statistic, and a p-value, as well as a 95% confidence interval. So let me show you an interesting trick here. Let's say this model considers BMI a linear relationship between BMI and BP systole. But what if we suspected there was a curvilinear, a curved or parabolic relationship here? I'm going to go to the history window here and click on regress BP systole BMI, and that will send that command back to the command window. And I'm going to modify this by typing a C dot in front of BMI. That's Stata's factor variable notation that tells Stata explicitly that BMI is continuous. And then I'm going to put two of these little sharps here, hashtags, followed by another C.BMI. And what this is going to do is ask Stata to create an interaction term between BMI treated as continuous and BMI treated as continuous. So that will create a main effect as well as an interaction term between the two, which is simply the square of BMI. So now when I press enter, I can see in my output here, I now have BMI, the linear coefficient for BMI, as well as a squared coefficient for BMI. Both of the p-values for these are very small by themselves, but if I wanted to test those simultaneously, I could actually type test BMI space BMI, and then put the little hashtag in there, and then BMI again. So that's the interaction of BMI, or the squared term for BMI. And what that will do is simultaneously test that both of those, the null hypothesis, that both of those coefficients are equal to zero simultaneously. So I get an omnibus F statistic here as well as a p-value for that F statistic. Okay. The next thing we might want to do is create some marginal predictions from our models. So let's go to statistics and scroll way down to the almost to the bottom where it says post-estimation. So I'm going to click post-estimation. And this opens the post-estimation selector where I can select all kinds of things after I fit my model. I can do goodness of fit analyses, diagnostic plots, predictions, all kinds of things. So I'm going to select marginal effects of estimated means and interactions. So I'm going to expand that. And let's just keep this simple and do basic and low dimensional analysis. There are lots of other things we could do, but let's start off simply here. Click launch. And then at the top of the margins dialog box here, I can select the type of covariate. I have a continuous covariate here, BMI, and the covariate that I'm interested in is BMI. It's the only covariate in my model. I can select the analysis type. There are other things that I could do, elasticities and things like that, but let's just again keep this simple. So I want to compute the estimates at values of BMI. Let's say I want to estimate systolic blood pressure at a BMI of 20, in increments of 10 through 60. So I'm going to type 20, 10 in parentheses, followed by 60. So BMI of 20 to 60 in increments of 10. And then I'm going to leave everything else the way it is and just click OK here. So let me move this over and let's take a look at what we have. So the dialog box issued the command margins, followed by comma at BMI equals 20 through 60 in increments of 10. You can see that right here in the results window. And then in the results, what it's going to do is estimate the predicted systolic blood pressure at BMI equals 20, BMI equals 30, and 40, and 50, and 60. So these ats tell me what the expressions are down below. So I can see that at BMI of 20, the predicted systolic blood pressure is about 120.6757. And I get a standard error, a t-statistic, a p-value, as well as a 95% confidence interval over here. Now if I wanted to, I could graph that. I could create a graph from that. If I go back to the post-estimation selector, I can select profile plots after marginal analysis, click launch, and then over here, I'm going to select the in the main tab, I'll select the variables that define the x-axis. That's going to be at BMI, at those predictions that I generated. So then I'm going to click OK, and that will then create a plot of my marginal predictions at BMI of 20, 30, 40, 50, and 60. So it's a plot, and the vertical axis here is the predicted systolic blood pressure. So I've created a plot from my model. Okay, so let's close these dialog boxes, and I want to show you a fun trick. If I go over here to the history window, and I right-click and select all, and then I right-click again and select send selected to do file editor, what that will do is send all of those commands that the dialog box has generated, it will send them all to the do file editor. And then I could save this, and I could rerun it anytime I want. It also shows me all of the options that I had for all of those commands. So this is a nice quick way to learn new options by using the dialog boxes and then see the commands later. Okay, so that's how we can fit a linear regression model with a continuous predictor and test some hypotheses after and estimate some marginal predictions and create some plots. So I hope this was helpful. Thanks for stopping by.